also did some football for WTVS and a few other places like that. I saw you in Washington, I think.
A minute 30 to go in the game. Oklahoma State with a six-point lead in the basketball. Cowboys have got to get it in. Then they've got to get it across the timeline. Melvin Gilliam in backcourt. Some pressure knocked away by Dave Seeger, and the referee said the foul is against Tim McAllister. Late whistle, too. I believe is that four or five on McAllister?
How many are in
that's
five.
That's it. And there goes the outside shot. McAllister will not beat the Cowboys for the third straight year with a last-second shot or free throw.
He finishes with 7 points unofficially. He has three field goals, one free throw.
McAllister doesn't believe he has five fouls. The board shows five. Elvin shows five. If Elvin shows five, he's got five.
Billy Tubbs doesn't believe it either. Look at him. That's five fouls, Coach.
If you can look at Billy Tubbs' face, it is red. He does not believe. I thought McAllister only had four myself.
I thought it was five, but I'm not keeping scores, so.
It's five. Elvin says it's five. He's gone. And even more important than that, and I believe Elvin, is that the official score says it's five, and that counts for everything at this point. And Billy Tubbs is really giving the official a time. Now, Billy doesn't want to pick up a technical at this stage. It would be four free throws.
Seeger checked in a few moments ago, too, and that after that last timeout, that's, I think, his first appearance tonight.
I thought he might have been the one to commit the foul, but they caught it on McAllister. The crowd shouting T. And they're not encouraging Tubbs with the T. There's Billy. Oh, the tie came off, too. There's a minute and 26 to go in the game. Melvin Gilliam, the freshman out of Tulsa, goes to the foul line. Now, Oklahoma State leads by six at 80-74. Now they say that they're going to make Seeger check in. He was already in the game. They're going to make him check in again. I just want to get a good close-up.
Billy is really going nuts. Blood pressure will get to you in a game like this.
Melvin Gilliam at the line, 68% on the year, 71% in Big 8 play. He changed his shooting style from the line just a little bit. He'll jump at the release. It's a 7-point Oklahoma State lead at 81-74, a minute 26 to go in the game. That's still a long time. Melvin is in double figures. It's an 8-point lead at 82-74, and what the Cowboys will do is simply pack the zone and make the shooters shoot the long range shot, although they get it into DJ's mouth. They're only going to take a shot, and that might wrap up the ballgame right here. Melvin Gilliam, nice play. Passed up and in, but it will not count because he was fouled before Andre Ivey came up with the tackle.
I'll tell you what, though, you give Andre Ivey lots of credit on that defensive side of the court. Came up with a big steal there. Just kind of batted the ball away.
Andre Ivey. Oh, incredible. I think the people here feel this one. With a minute and 13 to go in the game. That's five fouls on Linwood Davis. So the Cowboys were the ones in serious foul trouble with Vegas, Ivey, and Bannister with four each. Yet it's two Sooners that foul out of the game first. And remember the big discrepancies in fouls early in this half. It tends to equal out, though, when you're at home. Kelly Fitz is coming to the ballgame now for Oklahoma. Melvin Gilliam has stood down the job here down the stretch, really throughout the game tonight. That ought to do it. It's a 9-point lead for Oklahoma State. And Sooners are going to battle here the last minute of the season. At the end of the Big 8 tournament, it will be Oklahoma State against Nebraska, and it will be Oklahoma against Missouri on Friday in this first round game. Shue Kennedy with the rebound. Melvin with 15 points. His career high is 18, so enjoying one of his final games against the Sooners. It's not over yet.
Anthony Boone,
long range jumper. And even 1 minute to go in the game. Backcourt with it, Melvin Gilliam across the.
Anthony Bowie has just fouled out.
The Cowboys want it in Melvin Gillum's hand. What a position to put a freshman in. The Cowboys, in essence, are sending Melvin Gillum to the line for the one and ones, putting it in his hand.
You know, it is amazing to me, though, that no matter what the call, the coaches never agree with it. You know, you think, like you said, it. Once in a while, there's no doubt that was a foul. It was right in front of us. I mean, you know, once in a while, your guys are going to make mistakes, you know?
What they're saying now, though, the Sooner bench anyway is, you know, for F, that's three of our guys that are gone. None of theirs have gone yet.
They'll rub it into the guys in the zebra shirts. What a tough job they have, isn't it?
57 seconds to go in the game. Melvin Gillum.
Chuck Watson will come into the game to replace Lindo Davis. Billy Tubbs taking his entire time trying to ice the freshman. It's been a long time since Gallagher has run like this. Paul Hanson's record against the Sooners coming in tonight, 2-6 here in Stillwater, 4-10 overall. His final game in Gallagher.
These are big free throws. He's hit three out of four down the stretch.
Paul Hanson hasn't relaxed on the bench yet, fellas. He's chewing on that gum like crazy.
It's an 8-point Oklahoma State lead. Your freshman from Tulsa, Washington, played a big role tonight for Paul Hanson's team. 9-point lead.
That's a career high for Melvin Gillum. Isaac.
They wanted a foul against one of the Cowboys on Keith Kennedy, and where we sat, it looked like a foul.
It looked like a foul, but the Sooners were still out of the basketball. 46 seconds. Big thing here, the Cowboys can just hold it after the Sooners get off the shot. The shot clock will be turned off in 1 second.
Duke Kennedy right there to get it down. 40 seconds to go in the game. Oklahoma State with the ball. Mitch Jones. Mitch lost control of the ball, went off the bottom of the basket. Terry Fagans gets it. Fagans is fouled by either Watson or Kennedy.
Well, Mitch Jones lost it.
Jones could have iced it. He turned around and lost the control of it, and that would have done it, and it will be over anyway. But
do you think that was just a little excitement on a senior chance to give Paul a victory, and he just lost it, just thinking about it too much? Chu Kennedy was trailing on the play, which I found interesting because Chu missed one of those against Kansas, and he had a good eyeball saying, I know how you feel, Mitch.
Terry Fagans.
His first miss from the line.
85-78, Oklahoma State by 7. Conley Phipps, long range jumper. To Kennedy gets the pass.
Kennedy will not quit.
David Johnson and Alan Bannister exchange pleasantries, and Bannister is gone. That is his fifth. DJ a little bit frustrated. Billy's out there talking to the officials, and Johnson will go to the foul line and shoot two. With 20 seconds to go, of course, the game itself will be over. Three questions for 41. 10 points, four rebounds for Alan Bannister. Paul Hanson wants to talk about it with his team, and I think that's probably a wise move just to calm things down a little bit.
Oh, it's getting out of hand. Some ice just hit the floor right at the feet of Chief Kennedy, and you don't like to see that. A lot of it is just the emotion of the night involved, but some ice just thrown on the court. You really hate to see that.
You look at Billy Tubbs, who's got a great deal to say to the referees, and again, you know, let's not let things get out of hand here. It's a great win for Oklahoma State. There's no denying that. The Sooners had a great season, and we'll go on to the NCAA tournament no matter what happens in Kansas City. For Oklahoma State, this is a great way to end Paul Hanson's home tenure here at Gallagher Hall, and it assures him of no matter what, a winning season during this year.
What it also means at the Big 8 tournament, Bill, you don't want to play Kansas early. You really don't want to play Oklahoma early. You get Nebraska. The winner will likely meet Iowa State, who does not play that well away from their own Coliseum. It is a fairly easy draw per se. You'll always be playing a team that has a better record than yourself.
There is the possibility that Oklahoma State, by winning this game tonight, could be in position to win two games in Kansas City. Not saying that will happen necessarily. The Cowboys have not been that great throughout the year, but it's a tremendous win for them. It sets them up pretty good for Kansas City.
Well, it does. The only problem then is Nebraska
played so well without Hoffman. You're right.
How do you figure that out? I mean, how do you figure that out? One of the best players in the country goes down with an injury, and the team plays better than ever. Yeah, I was listening to the replay of the game we had at February 5th at Lloyd Noble. We talked about Dave Hoffman in the second half, and all three of us agreed Nebraska would probably not win another game after February 5th. I think they only lost once.
I changed my mind.
They have changed mine as well.
Let's finish it up now with 20 seconds to go. David Johnson goes to the foul line for Oklahoma. Melvin Gillum, 17 points tonight. His career high was 18 at Colorado. David makes the first to get another. It's a 6-point Oklahoma State lead with 20 seconds to go.
DJ has 9 points in the line tonight.
19 overall, make it 20. Look for the quick foul or steal attempt.
Eric Young is in. He's got some company in the backcourt.
he is fouled by either Washington Johnson, and Eric will shoot the one and one.
Eric's a 73% shooter, both on the year and in Big 8 play.
He's having some contact problems, it looks like. They're searching for his contact.
This is not a ploy to go out on a medical injury. He's got the contact right there, putting it back in his eye.
Tell me it wasn't a physical foul.
Yeah. 18 seconds to go. You know, if you don't hit these free throws, Sooner's still in this thing.
They can score so quickly. Two Kennedy still out there having a hot night. Conley Phipps can bomb it from outside. DJ down underneath. These are the key ones right here. It's going to be bedlam if the Cowboys win it. The fans are surrounding the court. They'll likely charge it, but they need to restrain themselves right now. Oh, is that Preston? Redshirt Preston does a great job. It's 86-80. Isn't it interesting that the Cowboys, all their free throws here down the stretch, with the exception of Fagan's, have been shot by Preston?
And they've made them.
And they've made them. It's a 7-point Oklahoma State lead, 87-80. Conley Phipps makes the move middle of the lane. His shot is good. Timeout for Oklahoma. Now, we got 11 seconds to go in the game. There's not really much that Oklahoma can do except foul as soon as the Cowboys get the ball inbound.
That is also the final timeout for the Sooners, so they can't use the same strategy again.
It's a 5-point lead, 87-82, 11 seconds to go in the game.
Obviously, you have to steal the inbounds play, Bill, or set up, try to take the charge and go to the line for the one and one.
You got to do something in a real hurry, and that's what Billy Tubbs is telling his crew right now.
Of course, Billy, you know, in fairness to the Sooners, they don't have their quick guys in there. McAllister, Bowie, and Linwood Davis are all sitting on the bench for five, so it's kind of tough to make that steal. I mean, Chu would be your next quickest guy in there.
What a difference emotion and home court play. The Sooners defeat the Cowboys, taking an 11-0 lead, never look back. I believe the Sooners led one time tonight, 16-14, if they even led then. The Cowboys have controlled it. The Sooners made a big run at them in the second half, had a chance to cut it to two, and the Cowboys immediately got it back out to 10.
You know, what a way, though, to end up your career as coach at home anyway for Paul Hanson tonight. Let's face it, I think everybody likes Paul Hanson. He's the type of guy that you can't help but like, and it's nice to see a guy go out a winner who's got that kind of reputation and is that kind of guy. And, of course, the Sooners have bigger and better things to look forward to. They've got not only the Big 8 tournament, but, of course, the NCAA's coming up.
11 seconds to go in the game, and the Cowboys have the ball out of bounds. They have to bring it the length of the floor. Basically, they simply have to get it in bounds, and when they do, Oklahoma will foul. They have no other choice. 5-point game, 87-82, as you look at Paul Hanson.
Billy Tubbs positioning his troops.
Melvin Gunn, now he can move on that baseline whichever way he wants to go, but he's simply got to get it in.
Oh, Billy Tubbs is going to be irate about this one. Seager,
you have to do that within 3 seconds. It was awful close.
It was awful close to getting a turnover. Billy's back on the court again. And a technical. It was bound to happen. And that will seal the game if the Cowboys can hit the technical. Because they've got four. Well, if they're on an out-of-bounds play, they'll get the technicals, then the ball in the forecourt.
Well, Billy's been chewing on the officials all night, and that's going to happen eventually.
Well, that definitely does it. There's no question about that, because the Cowboys, even if they miss the foul shots, they've got the ball in their own front court.
Billy has really given it to the official. He's already got his technical. He's going to get his money's worth. What, Billy had two things to be upset about. First of all, he thought his player drew the charge. Second, he didn't think Gillum got the timeout called in time. The official, what happened, he looked over at what he may have been the charge call, then looked back and saw the timeout and called it. So maybe the waiting of the official may have made it past that 3 seconds, but whatever it is, Billy does not like it.
Been a long last couple of minutes, that
sure has. This is no doubt about that. Game figured to be over with around 10. We're at 10:15, 10:16 now, and hope you've enjoyed it. Stay tuned for the news in Tulsa and Oklahoma City. We'll be on in just a few minutes when the game is over with, and Stevens in Tulsa, Tony Sellers in Oklahoma City. We're talking about this game tonight.
Kind of an interesting tidbit here. McAllister, before he fouled out, scored only 7 points tonight, which is his tying his season low, which he also had against Missouri earlier this year.
Kennedy has 29 points, Bowie 16,
David Johnson with 20 points. Fagans with 20 for the Cowboys. Bannister 10, Ivy 10, Gillum 10. Fagans also with his 20 points, 11 rebounds. As Gillum misses the first technical shot. But Terry Fagans tonight, 20 points, 11 rebounds. We mentioned he had been quiet at one stage of the second half, Bill. That was about the time he took over and gave the Cowboys a nice lead. Gillum missed them both.
Melvin, who hit some big ones in the last 3 or 4 minutes, missed them both. But again, the key thing is the Cowboys have the ball out of bounds.
No pressure on those. With the midcourt.
I tell you what, these fans are going to come charging out here in 11 seconds.
Mitch Jones will go to the line. Nice chance for the senior. 11 seconds here. No time off the clock. David Johnson comes in. He replaces Anthony Martin, who goes back to the bench. He was in there briefly for Oklahoma. Mitch Jones will go to the foul line. 87-82. Weldon Drew and Paul Anson are asking, hey, the ball came in bounds. Why didn't the second go off the clock? And they're quite upset about it. We're home,
folks. It's funny you take a look at what a guy does. Now, Mitch has only got 7 points tonight, but a lot of them have been spectacular from him. That was good quickly. 8 seconds, 7 seconds. Fifth shot is good.
Cowboys don't have to inbound it.
Emotional time for Paul.
College basketball at its best, folks. The emotion of the game, it can't be matched.
All right, the Cowboys win it 87-84, and we're back in just a moment.
Someone just asked me why I wasn't flying the plane.
And you said,
I'd love to, Captain.
Anyway, we're on vacation. Can't they tell we're on vacation?
Now, why does that look familiar?
Because we've been there. I like it better here.
You'll like Hawaii, and you'll love the fare on Western Airlines. It's the only way to fly.
I'll admit there are a few things you won't find here at Kuppenheimer. There's no factory rejects, no seconds, no out-of-date styles, no last year's fabrics, and no cheaply made suits from the Far East. What you will find are Kuppenheimer suits made in my own factory, sold only in my own stores, and there's no middlemen, which is why a Kuppenheimer suit doesn't cost you $250 or even $200, but just $145.
Stores in Oklahoma City and Tulsa.
Today, most people treat their small change like it was no big deal. But right now at Hardee's,
the big deluxe, please.
A little change adds up to the thickest, juiciest quarter-pound burger of them all. Just $1.19 for Hardee's new big deluxe. A lot of burger for not a lot of change.
Hardee's, where good people go for good food.
Special allocation sale. Your Big 8 Ford dealers have even larger selections and lower prices on the number one best-selling car and truck in Oklahoma. Ford has awarded the Big 8 Ford dealers a special allocation of Escorts and Rangers with prices starting at $59.95. Choose from the largest selection in Oklahoma. Buy now because the volume discounts have never been bigger. See your Big 8 Ford dealers today because they have more affordable Ford.
Big 8 Ford.
There is no other way to describe it. One of the most emotional nights in the history of this great building. 87-84, Oklahoma State, Oklahoma. And you're going to see right there the going away present for Paul Hanson as he cuts down the net.
Paul Hanson gets to get the trophy tonight. Just to our left is the Hanson family. There's not a dry eye along the row. Carol Hanson just gave us a thumbs up sign. A very emotional night for the entire Hanson family.
Well, there's no question that it's a big win for Oklahoma State. It sets him up against Nebraska in the first round of the Big 8 postseason tournament on Friday. The Sooners will definitely play Missouri. I don't know the times in those games yet because the pairings will be announced tomorrow. Cowboys have a little bit of momentum going in. Cowboys win it tonight, 87-84. For Ed Murray and for Bill Teekins, I'm John Snyder. We hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you very much for watching. Good evening from Gallagher Hall.
Tonight's game has been brought to you in part by Coors and Coors Light, beers with a difference worth tasting.